Hello from Chem Help ASAP. In this video, we're going to show different methods for communicating organic structure. So there are three columns on the slide, one for molecular formula, one for condensed structural formula, and one for a Lewis dot structure. So we're going to look at two very simple molecules, and we're going to fill in this table. So we're going to start with methane. Simple molecule that we've written simply the molecular formula. And the molecular formula, any organic molecular formula, is written so that we first write the number of carbons, the carbon C with the number of carbons. In this case, it's just one, so we don't have to put the number. Then we list the number of hydrogens. Then all other elements are listed in ABC order, alphabetical order. So bromine would come before fluorine, would come before sulfur, that kind of thing. So there is a structure, a method to writing molecular formulas. Now the condensed structural formula is a way to communicate in a line what the structure is. Now, unfortunately, methane is so simple it doesn't really have much of a condensed structural formula. Looks remarkably like the molecular formula. But we'll see in the next example that there is an actual method to communicating condensed structural formulas. The Lewis dot structure is meant to explicitly show connectivity of the atoms. So for methane, we have a carbon in the middle, and it's an sp3 hybridized carbon. So we have four bonds coming off of carbon to give it its octet rule, and those are all to a hydrogen. So this is the Lewis structure. Lewis dot structures don't have to be written exactly like this. Technically, this could be the Lewis structure for methane, although I think most people like to spread the hydrogens out evenly. But that right-hand structure does communicate the structure, so that's a valid Lewis structure. Okay, let's go down to ethane. Ethane, here's our molecular formula, C2H6. And for its condensed structural formula, we would write this. Now, condensed structural formulas are typically written from left to right, and they are read from the left to right as well. Notice that we sort of write down, here's our carbon, and what's going on with that carbon, what's attached to that carbon, and then we move on to the next carbon. And we write down that C, and then fill in the groups that are on that C. The Lewis dot structure for ethane, we have two carbons connected to one another, and then hydrogens are used to fill out the valence and give us full octets for both of our carbons. Again, how we draw this molecule, we could draw it more vertical. That would also be a valid Lewis dot structure. Lewis dot structures are really trying to show the connectivity of the atoms in a method that's a little more explicit than what you see in the condensed structural formula. So those are three ways of communicating composition or molecular structure within organic chemistry.